Welcome, scholars, to our chapel worship. It's great to have you here and focusing on God's Word. Reminder to respond and speak out loud and show that Jesus is worth it. Adults, if you're listening on in, participate with your children. Today we open our ears and we say, "Speak, O Lord, about your glory." We see Jesus' glory at his transfiguration, and we also know that is the glory that he will share with us because he was willing to go to the cross. Let's worship our Savior Jesus. Grace to you, Hope Scholars. We worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen. Let's fold our hands and read this prayer together. Dear faithful Lord, we honor you for being holy and pure and powerful. Open our hearts to learn about your word. Open our minds to learn about your world. Train us to follow you to serve others. Amen? Amen. Let's say our key Bible passage together. The Lord is trustworthy in all he promises and faithful in all he does. Psalm 145, verse 13. This week we've been looking at the virtue of respect. God's power for you to honor him and others. And we see Jesus deserves our respect. He even can command it because we see his glory on that Mount of Transfiguration. But we don't always give it to him. And we don't respect always the others that he has put as authorities over us. And so this week, again, I found myself as a sinner. And I'm sure you were sinful too. So let's confess so we can hear that good news of how Jesus glorifies us and forgives us. Please join me in the confession. Dear God, I am sinful. I do not always honor you. I disrespect people as well as you. Forgive my sin because of Jesus. God loves you and forgives you because of Jesus. Jesus died on the cross for all people, including those that disrespected him. He honored his Father by glorifying him by obediently saving the world. Jesus did this to lift us up and make us God's holy children. Amen? Amen. God's message for you is this: couch, never. Cross, now. Crown, forever. I'll tell you about that in a little bit, explain it a little bit. But just recall our story this week where Jesus took three of his disciples up to a mountain, and there he showed his glory. He just revealed who he was as true God. He was true human, but he let them see his divine glory. And there was no mistaking. That was God. Jesus was God, and they got to see Moses and Elijah as well. And Peter thought this was a good thing. Like, can we stay here? Let's put up some tents. I like this glory. And I think that's a good thing. You and I crave. We're built to be with God and his people in glory forever. That's the way it's supposed to be. So I understand where Peter was coming from, but he didn't understand how life worked in this sinful, broken world, that you don't get the glory now. You don't get the glory now. You get it in heaven, and right now, we need to follow Jesus, and we need to carry our cross, which means we carry the suffering and pain and service we need to do in this life to serve others, to give God glory, and God's going to get us through it. We see the disciples suddenly at the end all alone with just Jesus, and he had no more glory. And they went down the mountain, and they headed towards the cross, where Jesus said he was going to suffer and die and rise from the dead, and they just didn't quite understand it. And so we struggle with understanding how we have to suffer and carry our cross in this world, but Jesus will get us through it. To help us think about that, I want to ask you, what would you like to do tomorrow? I mean, if you could do anything tomorrow, what would you like to do? Well, here's some options for you to think about. Would you sit in your room and play video games? Would you want to go to a Bucks game or watch it on TV if that's all you can do? Would you like to enjoy lunch at Stonefire Pizza? Or would you choose to go clean the home of an elderly person? Maybe it's your grandma. You go clean her house, or maybe it's a neighbor. Maybe you shovel their snow. Who knows what you do, but you go serve and work. Now, those first three sound pretty fun, but maybe you thought about the last one. If you did, that's fantastic. And that's what Jesus has called us to do, because Jesus sets the example by choosing to serve and give up the glory. There's glory in those first three. There's service and humility in the bottom one. What did Jesus choose to do in his life? He could have chose to do anything. He could have stayed in heaven. He could have stayed there and he'd have been just fine. He could have chose to come to this world and glow with that power all the time and just wipe people out and judge them. He could have chosen that, but instead, He chose this, to be arrested, to suffer death and hell, to pay for the sins of the world, including his enemy. Jesus chose to suffer. He had every option in the world. Nobody was making him clean his grandma's room, right? He chose to do it. He wanted to do it. And that's what's amazing. Jesus had all that glory, but he chose to make himself nothing to pay for our sins. And so when I ask, this is based upon our title, what C do we have? I mean, I'll put the three up. You know, it's across the couch, the couch, the cross, the crown. The couch, Jesus never calls us to do that. Jesus never just took it easy for the sake of taking it easy. This life is not about just ease and pleasure and like sitting back. That's not what this life is about. And Jesus never did that. Is this life about the cross? Yeah. Jesus, everything was there to serve the world and go to the cross. And that's what you're called to do too. To serve others, to care the tough times, to even put up with people not liking you because you follow Jesus. Because it all leads to the crown. It all leads to the crown, right? It's not the couch, right? It's the cross, but finally it's the crown. Jesus will have you reign with him forever by his grace. And that's what we're looking forward to. But like Peter, James, and John, it's not necessarily right now. Now, how do we get through that? How do we get through this life? Well, by the power that Jesus gave us on the cross. Put those four fingers up for me. Jesus died for me. Amen. That's how we know we have the power to make it through our life, because Jesus carried the greater cross, carried all our punishment, and gave us heaven. So let's review what this story teaches us. Well, Jesus is true God who deserves respect from all, and he'll get it on the last day. We see him in his glory. We also see that if that's who Jesus is, that he chose not to use his power. He chose not to use his power so he could go to the cross and suffer and die for us. We see God calls us to choose and suffer and look forward to glory in heaven. He calls us to the cross, not the couch, so he can eventually give us that crown. So if you know Jesus went to the cross for you and that you will get glory in heaven, let me hear you say amen. Amen indeed. Let's join together now for the song, Mighty to Save. Oh, wrong one.
Love that's never failing.
Let's say John 3:16 together. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16. Let's fold our hands and pray. Dear Jesus, we thank and praise you for being our God, for being glorious and amazing and all-powerful, and also all-loving, that you chose to love us and give up your glory and suffer and die for us. Lord, help us carry our cross. Help us find ways to serve. Be willing to serve others the way that you have served us. Lord, we ask you to keep us safe. Be with us, bless us, help us go forward this school year. Bless our community and our nation, and give us everything that we need. Lord, move us more and more towards the crown that you'll give us in heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God is faithful. The Lord is faithful. Let's fold our hands and join in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Receive the blessing from our God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Thanks so much for worshiping with me. I look forward to seeing you and seeing you around in this world, but I do look forward to seeing you in heaven, where we'll be in that glory. God's blessings.